What's up, y'all? It's your girl Canelia back for another episode of Black News, a podcast where we break down current events, hot topics, and local stories involving Black people. Now let's get into it. CNN done fired Don Lemon, honey. Okay, CNN done fired Don. Honestly, I didn't expect this, and I never thought I would see the day. I did not. I thought Don was going to go down when he felt like going down. And yes, there have been lots of conversations and speculations and things coming out about Don and his behavior behind the scenes over the last year. But again, I never thought this would come to this. So back up. Don Lemon been on CNN for the last 17 years. He has been a staple on CNN. And let me say this, Don Lemon has taken a turn, because if y'all remember, there was a good chunk of time where, when it comes to the Black community, Don Lemon wasn't our favorite guy. I'm gonna keep it a buck. There was a time where us as Black people, we would see Don Lemon, he would be on there talking, and some of the stuff he would be saying, we'd be like, I don't know, Donnie Don. I don't know. But over the years, especially I would say the last maybe 5-6 years, he's really started to align himself more with, I not only want to say Black people, because Black people are not a monolith. We are different and we have different thoughts and opinions. But I would say he has been becoming on more side of sticking up for Black people and what Black people got to say and what's going on with us. I personally don't think that was always the case, but maybe I'm wrong. Anywho, Don Lemon, over the last, I would say, year or so, there have been allegations about his conduct. They were saying he was a diva behind the scenes, that he, when he was like 41, he was dating a 22-year-old that worked in the newsroom. All kinds of things have been coming out, and which is not abnormal in this time period that we're in. We are not necessarily, people keep talking about we in a like cancel culture. We in a gotcha culture, where people be digging and hoping to get you on something. They be trying to catch you up on stuff. So it is not uncommon for everybody in news, especially CNN, to get called out about something. Hell, Chris Cuomo got called out because he was sticking up for his brother and was doing something like communicating about the case, or it was something crazy with Chris. Remind me, because I don't necessarily remember. I just knew I liked Chris, seeing Chris on my news, and when he was gone, I was feeling the kind of way. Whatever. So, with this Don Lemon news, it was shocking, because again, some of the stuff that we've seen people being fired for did not seem to align in this case. Also, though, throwing in there the TJ Holmes, old TJ got ousted from ABC because him and what's her name had a relationship. So, now that I'm thinking about it, it could go either way. But news broke today, and it broke after we saw that Tucker Carlson was ousted from Fox News. And people are assuming that that is because Fox News recently got sued by the company that the Fox News correspondents were lying on in regards to voting machines and the election between Trump and Joe Biden. Some people also saying low-key that they don't necessarily think that Tucker Carlson left with no opportunities. They think he got something else in the can. But we don't know, and this ain't the platform to talk about Tucker Carlson. We're talking about Don Lemon, okay? So when the news broke, Don tweeted, this is what Don had to say. Quote, I was informed this morning by my agent that I have been terminated from CNN. I am stunned. After 17 years at CNN, I would have thought someone in management would have had the decency to tell me directly. At no time was I ever given any indication that I would not be able to continue to do the work I have loved at the network. It is clear that there are some larger issues at play. With that said, I want to thank my colleagues and the many teams I've worked with for an incredible run. They are the most talented journalists in the business, and I wish them all the best. Honey, the tea's hot. What happened? Because Don said they ain't give him no information. Like, he was kind of out of nowhere. But then adding, CNN responded a little later and said that Don's assertions, okay, about his termination were not true. They said, Don Lemon's statement about this morning's events is inaccurate. He was offered an opportunity to meet with management, but instead released a statement on Twitter. That's what they said. Now, was he offered the opportunity to meet with management after he was given the news or before he was given the news? Because that really makes a difference. When you get fired, I want the conversation before I get fired. Give me the written notice. Did he get the written notice with the improvement plan? Did they put him on a performance plan and say, Don, according to the performance plan, if these X, Y, and Z things don't change or you don't make adjustments, we will have to take further action. Did Don receive that? Was Don put on the performance plan? Or was he given the axe? Then they said in the termination meeting, if you want to talk to somebody, we can. Hey, those two different scenarios. Either way, I don't know if we'll know any time soon what happened. Because hell, we still don't know what happened to Tiffany Cross over on MSNBC. We don't know what happened to Tiffany. Okay, Tiffany, one day we thinking it was going to tune in on Saturday, and then Tiffany was off the air. So who knows? They're also having conversations over the social medias that Gayle King and Charles Barkley will be joining CNN in a show. And the bag that Gayle is demanding, that's a big bag. So some people are saying they had to make room for Gayle, so somebody had to go, and the person that they chose to let go in this case was Don. I don't know, but I do know that Don and Gayle's audiences may not necessarily overlap. Gayle is currently on CBS. And the journalist that Don has turned into, Don be challenging these panelists. When people be on there lying and talking crazy, he now be biting back and challenging. We haven't seen Gayle do that. Hell, R. Kelly was going crazy and Gayle was calm and cool and collected, okay? Cool as a cucumber. So I don't necessarily know or think we going to get from Gayle what we going to miss from Don. And I don't know of anybody at CNN right now who is going to provide that space. And then Charles Barkley, like, I don't know what that's about. No disrespect to Charles, okay? He got his lane on Inside the NBA and he is who he is, but CNN viewers ain't really checking for no Charles Barkley commentary. I don't know if they really know their audience. So I don't, that right there is confusing because he don't fit in. Charles Barkley, low-key, he more likely should have been over on Fox News. He need to be taking Tucker Carlson's spot because they the same crowd on the low, though. But whatever. What do y'all think? What will y'all miss? Personally, I'm going to miss Drunk Don Lemon on New Year's Eve because y'all already know it's not this past year because they shut it down. They didn't let Don and Andy and Anderson drink on air for the New Year's Eve celebration. But them past years, honey, Don Lemon was on there drunk, singing. He had his mama on Zoom when we was during the quarantine. He got his ear pierced on live. He was talking to Dulce one night about what we wanted for the new year. And Dulce told Don live on air that she ain't want no more broke dick, honey. I'm talking about good times. We gonna miss this. I'ma show Miss Don. And I hope he gets picked up for another news outlet or platform. The question is, where can Don go? Where can Don go? So if people got that big bag, and depending on location, because at this point in his career, Don ain't trying to be moving and bopping around no more. But depending on where they got that big bag, if Gayle officially leaves CBS, Don could low-key get back into network TV. Don't sleep, they got money. But again, that's early. And Don, I don't know if he really want to do that at this point in his career. Also, TJ Holmes and Old Girl left the vacant spot. They did replace it with I forget what the guy's name is. But show he can go. Don, you want to be on ABC? That's prime spot. Right after GMA. But low-key, Don bigger than GMA. Or they about equal. So who knows? What are y'all thinking? Where will he land? I'm very interested to see what happens. Hit me up with your thoughts on social media at Cornelia. Before I even start this, spoiler alert in regards to Snowfall. We will be talking about Snowfall. Spoiler alert. If you have not caught up on Snowfall and watched the finale, go ahead and log out, Playboy. Go on, log out, Playgirl. The homies and the homettes. If you have not finished watching Snowfall, go ahead and log out. We're going to talk about it. We're going to talk about it. And you know, I'm talking about it. I usually bring up TV shows and whatnot only, you know, a little bit, not having like extensive conversation. But in this instance, you know, a show is good when it causes so much conversation. And that's what Snowfall did. The finale of Snowfall, when I'm recording this, it came out last week. The back end of last week, after I dropped this episode. And when I tell you, people was going at it on social media about this finale. And mind you, I just started watching Snowfall the last month or two. People kept talking about it. I tried a long time ago to get into it, and for some reason, it just wasn't clicking. That first season, those first couple episodes, I just couldn't get past it. So I gave it up. But then this final season, people kept talking about it. And one thing I ain't gonna let no good show with no black people in it pass me by. I'm gonna see what y'all talking about. As a student of entertainment and as someone who loves TV and film, I'm gonna watch to see what is hitting on. And even to magnify that point, people, y'all know this, people always compare the best dramas of all time. And The Wire has always, since Snowfall came out, been compared to this show. People have been saying, The Wire ain't better than Snowfall, or Snowfall and Wire. So because of that, I also finished The Wire, because I'm going to keep it a buck with y'all. I know The Wire was good for season one. It took me 7 years to get through season two of The Wire. I'm not joking. Y'all, it took me 7 years to get through season two of The Wire. But because people kept talking about Snowfall and comparing it, I first watched The Wire. Then I binge watched Snowfall and got done up into the finale the week the finale came out. And talk about timing. That ain't number God. Okay, that ain't nothing but our Father God. So let me say, Snowfall was a great show. John Singleton was one of the original creators, along with one of his producing partners in this particular instance. Y'all know John Singleton passed, I believe, around 2019-ish. And when they were probably getting out of season two. So y'all know, maybe y'all don't, when show creators die or something shifts. And even in this time period that we in, networks be quick to try to cancel the show. They be quick to try to get some shit off their books. So the fact that it still stayed on and was able to continue on through a finale and have a complete show in the passing of the person who was leading the charge, that's a fantastic thing. In addition to that, the cast. Listen, when I tell y'all Damson Idris be acting his ass off, y'all, Damson Idris, he the one. It's a lot of people who are the one, and I'm not saying he the one like he's the top dog, but it's a group of actors. When we talk about black men actors, it's a group of them that's out here. They killing it. Add him to the list. And they be British too. Listen, them Brits be whooping our ass on screen. They be whooping our ass. Maybe it's because they have more incentive to like properly train. As y'all know, in Hollywood, hell, somebody will move from goddamn Indianapolis to LA, take one acting class and be like, I'm gonna be on TV. It's just a different type of experience for us. Some people do be going to the Yales and the Juilliards and whatnot, but it's a lot of people in the business who only took acting classes for 6 months. But before I even continue with the Snowfall review, actors who out here killing it, Damson Idris, Daniel Kaluuya, Lakeith Stansfield, Trevante Rhodes, Yahya Abdul-Mateen II, okay? Corey Hawkins, like, it's so many young black actors that's out here doing it. And listen, the artist formerly known as Jonathan Majors, because before he got yammed up, he was on the list. So for the performances alone, bravo. Okay. Everybody's character on here was fantastic. So, and I keep saying, so I'm working on it, guys. I'm working on repeating certain phrases and words. So with that said, so Snowfall is based and it starts in the early 1980s in Los Angeles in South Central. Of course, we don't know John Singleton's work. That area and those stories are specific and important to him. But it starts around the time where cocaine is introduced to the hood and crack is then put onto the streets. Because y'all know, listen, y'all may not know or y'all may know, certain drugs were big in hoods, but nothing was as big and as dangerous and powerful as crack. There was heroin, there was powder cocaine, there was PCP, angel dust, sherm, all of these things. But once people started rocking up crack and selling it, that destroyed the black community. Simultaneously with how the CIA was involved behind the initiative to put crack in black neighborhoods in order to fund a particular war. All of that is covered in Snowfall. And it is loosely based. Some of the characters are loosely based on people who really existed in real life. So a lot of times people were saying, this should have been doing this and this should have happened. They were saying that because they wanted the story to mimic what happened to the people that the roles were kind of modeled behind. And I'll talk about that in a bit. But for example, people were saying that Franklin Saint, who Damson Idris plays, was loosely modeled around Freeway Ricky Ross, Rick Ross, the original Rick Ross, not the fat one. Angela, she plays the character Louie. They were saying that that character was modeled by a woman named Jamaica, who was a big drug king queenpin in Los Angeles. Uncle Jerome, they were saying it was modeled by the man that Jamaica was originally married to. His name was Daff. So there were people who were, you know, who were represented in this show as pieces from stuff that actually happened in scenarios and real experiences, but it was not an autobiography. With that, the finale turned social media completely out. And so let's talk about it, because I have questions to throw out to y'all about scenarios and what should or should not happen, if y'all liked it or not. Now, Franklin Saint, who Damson Idris plays, starts off in the series as a young, maybe 19-year-old, very smart young black man who has these aspirations to do things and live his life differently. We've even been seeing on social media people pulling up segments from the first episode where he said he wants to be free from it all. But Franklin pretty much postured himself as wanting to chart his own path and find his own way. But again, very smart. He was a very smart young black man. He ended up selling crack, which turned out the hood, completely destroyed the black neighborhood. He in turn becomes a kingpin of sorts. By the final season, we find out that he had in his possession and what he made that he was able to save $73 million. The money was then stolen by the CIA op that he was working with, Teddy. And Franklin goes on a downward spiral to get his money back, to get the $73 million back. A lot happened. Things happened. Relationships were lost. His mother ended up shooting a CIA agent. His girlfriend, he ended up choking her. His fiance, he choked her out after she said earlier, "Long, he ain't put his hands on me." So she took $800,000 from him and dipped. He could have divested from a large property that he was in, that he had money in, but he said no. He was gonna find a way to make it work. There were opportunities for Franklin to turn the corner. Whether you think Sissy, his mom, was wrong for shooting Teddy or not, whether you think Veronique was wrong for taking the money and dipping, that's another conversation. The question was around the ending. Franklin does all of that. And then we are flash forward throughout different events happening. So maybe 4 years total later from his original breakdown with the CIA op, he is now a wino who is damn near now, final episode, homeless and has completely lost everything. Y'all hear the word, the term broke, busted, and disgusted? That brother was broke, busted, and disgusted. I'm talking about he looked like the people in the community who he had a hand in their downfall, if that makes sense. Complete 180. Who Franklin was when he started is a completely different person at the end of the series. So the question would be for y'all, because this is what's been going on all on social media. Did it incorrectly? Should they have done something different? How would you have liked it to end? Honestly, I loved the ending. I thought it was very fitting. Sometimes I feel like we as people have this romanticized and idolized version or idea of this drug dealer life. And I charge it to one, people not really being around during the 80s and 90s, because a lot of people online are young. And if you're young and you like Gen Z, you don't remember the 80s and the 90s. You just remember the cleanup afterwards. You know the ramifications of it. You know what it was like for people, your parents and stuff, to be locked up, but you wasn't in out there. You didn't see it. In turn, people think them drug dealer shows and movies are how it really was. Power. We think about Power, BMF, all these shows. That ain't. Hey, that's glamorized. People forget that the lifespan of a drug dealer either ends with you dead, in jail, or having lost it all, or being smoked out, cracked out, lost your mind. That's what happened to Franklin. So I like the ending because people forget the idea that, one, mental health is a real aspect. People be losing their minds. And when I saw Franklin at the end, to me, it wasn't just about he fell off. He lost his mind. That really happens to people. People really be losing their marbles. And it represented him having to be left in the situation that he left so many people in his entire community. But then one of Franklin's last lines was, he's free. He's finally free. He don't have to change. He's free from the CIA on his back. He's free from selling dope. He's free from the responsibility. He done free from murdering. Because the boy been murdering, selling crack for 6 years. Let's keep it a buck. So I thought the ending was perfect. And I also think it was perfect because it did what it needed to be doing. The mark of a fantastic show is conversation. That's art. Some people were saying that they would have liked for him to die at the end. Like, you know, you get caught up in the drug game, stuff happen. It's a shootout. Somebody shot him. He shot somebody, whatever. End dead. Some people were saying that was the mark of to mark his true suffering and the cost that he would have had to pay. Some people were saying he should have gotten his money back. He should have gotten the $73 million back, or at that point, half the money back, and been able to get away. Some people wanted him to take the $12,000 that he got from Peaches and buy another brick, flip it, and go back to starting to the starting point and get back in the streets and at least make something back and then ride off into the sunset. Some people have attachment to Franklin the character because we've been watching him for 6 years, or they, because I've just been watching for the last couple of months. And they wanted him to win. You know, y'all know, we attach ourselves to people that we have been watching for so long. And because Franklin wasn't postured as necessarily the villain, people still wanted him to win. Even though technically a villain can't be considered somebody who's selling crack and murdering for 6 years. So what do y'all think should have happened at the end of Snowfall? I think it was perfect. There was also even an ode to John Singleton in there where they timed it perfectly with the jump in time forward so that Franklin was walking past him, and Leon, his best friend in the show, was walking past John Singleton's Boys in the Hood set. It was a very wonderful and beautiful, like, head tip of the hat to John. But again, what y'all think? How y'all think it should have ended? I thought it was perfect. It made me sad to watch. It was very difficult to watch. It was so hard to see that happen to Franklin. But again, I think what people need to understand and start to remember or do your research, crack destroyed black neighborhoods. Crack went from LA all the way to the Midwest, the South, the Northeast. Crack destroyed everybody. It tore up all of our communities. Then after that, simultaneously, while it was tearing up our communities, all of a sudden these laws got passed, and then it just snatched everybody up off the streets and threw them in jail. We know too much and have too much information to know that all of this isn't a coincidence. So the ending that Franklin got, personally, I think it was also to remind people not to glamorize the story and not to give them a happy ending, so we won't be out here in the world thinking all this shit is sweet, because it ain't. You destroy black communities, you need to go to jail, period. So did y'all watch? If you still listening, you have. And if you have not listened, I mean, if you have not watched and you still listening, maybe you like me. Spoilers don't hurt me. I can still watch something and after it's been spoiled. Hell, I actually appreciate it because my anxiety be too off the charts. So if I know what's coming, it's easier for me to lock in. But give me your thoughts on Snowfall. Hit me up at Cornelia on social media and let me know if you didn't watch or if you plan to check it out and how you thought the show should have ended. And real quick, I forgot to mention and talk about my ranking. People ask, where do you place Snowfall? A lot of people have been saying it's Above the Wire. It's the best drama they've ever seen. I still declare that Breaking Bad is the best television drama that has ever been created. I have not seen The Sopranos, so I cannot weigh on that. But people whose opinion I trust about TV, they do not put Sopranos above Breaking Bad. But from based on what I've seen and these three in conversation, I will always put Breaking Bad first. I will put The Wire over Snowfall, and I will put Snowfall over shows like Sons of Anarchy. Those are some of my favorites, but I do not put Snowfall above The Wire, and The Wire is not above Breaking Bad. Let me know what your top dramas of all times are, of all time is, and do you think Snowfall ranks at the very peak, the top for you? Hit me up and let me know. To recap this week's episode, we talked about Don Lemon being terminated from CNN and what could be possibly next for him in regards to his career and movement. We also talked about the season finale of Snowfall, our thoughts about that, and how you think the show should have ended. Did you like it or not? Hit me up on social media with your thoughts about All or None, and I'll check back in with you guys next time. That's it for this week's episode of Black News, y'all. Thanks again. Thank you. And thank you again so much for sticking with us, supporting the podcast, liking and subscribing on all apps where podcasts can be heard, rating 5 stars and leaving a comment. It helps more than you know. So I really, really appreciate it. And keep sharing Black News with all of your friends and family. Be sure to hit me up on social media if you got ideas for topics. Or just hit me up in general to let me know you've been listening. Let me know your thoughts. I'm at Cornelia on all platforms across the board. That's at Cornelia, like Kenny and Ophelia. Also, check my website. I got some shows coming up in Los Angeles County. Hopefully get on the road soon. But for now, if you're in the LA area, hit me up. Check Cornelia.com for show dates and details. And as always, thanks again so much, guys. I hope you have a fantastic week. Keep supporting, keep growing, keep building, keep staying safe, and keep staying healthy. As always, again, I'll see you back here next time, same time, same place. Bye.